Hi guys, welcome to this new video tutorial. In this video I will show you the easiest way how you could fix an external or internal hard disk which is no longer showing when plugged to your computer. This works for small hard disks and also the 3.5 inches hard disk. As you can see here, I have plugged my hard disk, but it shows like this. So what we are going to do, so we'll simply go to your search tab. Regardless if you have Windows 7, 8, 10, 11, or even 12, it's the same way. And we'll type create and format hard disk partition. We're going to click on it to open. And here, read the next letter to your hard disk name. So for example, here it shows as D, so I will need to locate D1. So here you can see it, for example. And as you can see, it shows RAW. So we're going to click on it with the right button of the mouse, delete volume, click yes. Please note that this method will not allow you to recover any data, because once the hard disk has reached this stage, any data in it is lost forever, unless you take it to an expert to recover it, but there is no other way to retrieve it by yourself. So what we are also going to do, we'll just re-click again, new simple volume. Click next. We'll leave the details by default. Click next. D. And we'll select next. Format this volume with the following settings: NTFS default. We'll name it RA disk. And perform a quick format and click next. Click finish. The formatting process will start and this should reallocate and make your hard disk working. Please note that usually after fixing your hard disk this way, you still have just few dozens of usage of the hard disk before it completely goes broken, because this problem will keep coming up and coming up again and again. So in the future, your hard disk will not be usable. So this is only to warn you, because I have already had this issue a few years ago with similar hard disks, and unfortunately it kept coming back. And at the end of the life of the hard disk, it started even every time when I plugged it, I had to do this process. So as you can see, I click on it, I open, and the hard disk is back. Next step, we'll just click to eject it. In this way, we can safely remove it. Thank you guys for watching, and talk to you soon in a new video tutorial.